गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग।
गिव मी 2 to 3 minutes, लेट मी एवरीवन।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग
सर। हाउ इज योर मदर?
मदर इज मच बेटर देन बिफोर। शी इज I think she'll be released in 2-3 days time.
Great. Good news.
Thank you.
Very good news.
Okay.
So, ladies and gentlemen, let me welcome Mr. Pradeep Chopra. Sir is a serial entrepreneur, an amazing guide, mentor, the beacon to the Indian entrepreneurial ecosystem. So, I'll be asking our community leader, Smriti, to formally welcome Pradeep, sir. Smriti, over to you, please.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. Today, we have Mr. Pradeep Chopra with us. Mr. Chopra is Chairman and Managing Director of PS Group of Companies based in Kolkata, and Chairman of iLead PS Group is a major player in Eastern India's real estate sector. He is an alumni of St. Xavier College, Kolkata. Mr. Chopra is also the President of Murshidabad Heritage Development Society. He has written several books on real estate, personality development, and relationships. He has contributed in many articles in national dailies. Mr. Chopra is very passionate about teaching, and he is a person of great expertise and knowledge. He calls himself a permanent learner. So now, let's hear from Mr. Chopra. Over to you,
sir.
Over
to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Arijit, for organizing this Zoom meeting. Let me first, a very warm welcome to all of you and a good evening. See, today, you know, the heading of the session is that get ready for the biggest business opportunity of your lifetime. Why am I saying this? There is a great business opportunity which is awaiting all of us when everybody else in the world, starting from the chief of IMF, our ex-governor of Reserve Bank of India, and all the economists, all the well-known financial experts are predicting doom, predicting recession as never before. They are all painting a very gloomy picture. The entire business fraternity, the entire, the most of the people of the world are scared, and some of them are really depressed. Everybody is thinking that some catastrophe is going to happen. In such a scenario, I am talking something which is absolutely different, just opposite. How can I say this when all these top thought leaders, thinkers, and experts in economy are predicting doom? What is the reason of my saying this? I'll just put before you certain facts, and then you can decide for yourself whom to believe, me or them. I'll leave it on you to take that judgment. Let me first tell you that India has always thrived when there was a crisis. I give you a few examples from the past. In 1960s, we had a tremendous shortage of food grains. So much so that we had to really beg food grains from the United States. Under PL 480 scheme, US sent us shiploads of grain, food grain. We didn't even have money to pay them. Ultimately, the Americans wrote it off. And then what happened? There was a green revolution, and India produced more grain than we can consume. Since then, we are consistently produce year after year more grain than we can consume. So much so that the government is scared that the so much grain is grown, if the market forces are unleashed, you know, the prices will fall below the cost for the, you know, farmer, and so therefore they have support prices so that they don't want the prices to go down. In spite of that, we are producing. We are one of the largest food grain producer in the world. Same thing happened for milk. We had a tremendous shortage of milk. Then we had this Operation Flood, and today we produce. We are the biggest producer of milk. We have so much milk we can't consume. In 1971, we had a great crisis. Our foreign exchange reserve went below $1 billion. We had barely foreign exchange to pay for the import of 1 week. We had Reserve Bank of India has to take our gold reserve to pledge in the Bank of England so that we have a credit line so that somehow we can buy our essential goods. And then the team of Manmohan Singh and Narasimha Rao started opening Indian economy. Everybody was very scared that, you know, if you open and if you allow foreigners to come and invest in India, they'll take over all the Indian companies. And all these doom predictor, you know, who said what happened was just opposite. Today we are very comfortable with over $400 billion of foreign reserve, which is much more than, you know, our requirement for almost 2 years. We have grown after that at a pace we never could think of. Till 1971, our growth rate was Hindu rate of growth 3%. After that, we touched 8.5%, some people say 9.5% growth rate. It was not the foreign company coming, buying Indian company. We went and bought their companies. You know, Tata's and Mr. Mittal, and so many people went and bought their companies. Yeah, just reverse happened. And we became like Asian tiger, or we were considered to be, or shortly we will become the third largest economy in the world. And people were thinking that India is the next superpower and all that. Had the 1971 crisis not happened, we would have never woken up to the fact that we need to abolish license for arbitrage. Had we not faced the crisis of food grain shortage in 1960s, we would have never become self-sufficient in food. So every crisis has taken India to the next level of development. This is our past. We are great crisis manager. I think this crisis will take our country to the next level of growth. Yeah, and this is why it will going to happen. And let me tell you this. Worldwide, there is more capacity to produce than we can consume. The problem is consumption, not production. We have everything. We can produce more than what we can consume. The entire global population can consume. Whatever they can consume, we have more production capacity. And this is leading to a kind of recessionary force, because everyone has more things to sell than the market can actually take. Same thing happened. You see, you will know that in China, there are ghost towns. They have built shopping malls. They have built housing complexes. There's no occupants. Same thing was happening in India. All builders, and let me tell you from real estate, because I come from real estate, we all had a lot of flats, unsold flats. Yeah, this was like a baggage. Every month, I had to spend good amount of money to pay interest on them, which is, you know, I borrowed money and I have to pay interest. I have to pay for their upkeeps. I have to pay municipal taxes. I have to pay for, you know, the cleaning and the operational cost, you know, the maintenance cost. Now what is happening, surprisingly, is that next 6 months, no construction will happen. Government itself has said, okay, no six, we are giving you extension of 6 months for finishing your project under RERA. And, you know, the construction companies are also given extra 6 months. Is not enough, because 3 months are already gone. And it is very difficult to, you know, come to the normal level of construction level in the next 3 months, because the workers have gone home. Our supplier's worker has also gone home. Today, if you go in the market, you will not get enough cement. You will not get tiles, because all factories are closed for the last 3 months. And this is not only happening in India, it's happening worldwide. the production suddenly has come to a halt, but our consumption, our need to consume cannot come to a halt. We have to eat every day. If our cars are aging, after a while, it will be cheaper to buy a new car than to run an old car and waste time and energy and money. If I have a cycle which is, completed its life cycle, I have to go and buy a cycle. There are more than, 10 crore cycles today operating in Indian rural areas. So everything has a life. And with passage of time, the life is getting over. And therefore, I have to buy. Let's take, for example, suppose I'm eating bhujia. The bhujia is not produced because factories are closed. Now, what I'm eating is coming out of their storehouse. What was in the pipeline? What was in the distributors go down? What was in the dealers go down? What was in the retailers go down? And what was in my house? Once all this is exhausted, then suddenly all of us go and want to buy bhujia. The manufacturer can't produce so much of bhujia in one day. So what manufacturer will do? He'll put his conditions. He'll say, I'll only give these bhujias to people who will give me advance payment. And I can only sell it for 15% higher price. Now, a person who eats bhujia, he doesn't mind pay. He'll pay 15% higher price. Yeah, because there's no bhujia. There's no flats. You see, in the last 3 months, if you believe me, more than 10,000 flats which were not getting sold are sold. In next 1 year, hardly any flat will be completed by builders because there will be a lot of problems in completing. If suppose you are under pressure to buy a flat, you have to buy because you have to get your son married and you need another flat and you need also a bigger flat because now you want to work from home and you can't work in the existing flat size because you need an extra room. There'll be different various reasons for, and this is happening already. Flats are getting sold. See, earlier, as a builder, I was under pressure because my construction was going on in a site and I had to pay money to my contractor, to my cement supplier, to my steel supplier. I could not stop my construction because if I stop, the wrong news is go in the market and then I'll get into a problem. So I have to continue that. Today, all the constructions are closed. So even if I wanted to close construction earlier, I was not able to do, but now everybody's construction is closed. So my outflow of money is stopped, but my inflow is continuing. So in fact, my cash flow position has improved, has not gone bad.
Yes.
I am under no pressure today because there's no pressure of cash. And then what happens now, since I am free from a pressure of cash, I'll now put my conditions because I know half of my flats are already sold. Now I said, look, I don't want to sell. My price is 20% higher. Take it or leave it. What is going to happen now? That suddenly the whole market will change from buyer's market to seller's market because there'll be shortage of goods in every field. Even that there'll be shortage of goods in the foreign countries, in the international market. And when there is a shortage of any item, the prices goes up, it doesn't go down. And there's too much cash surrounding. $10 trillion are going to be printed by foreign governments starting from America, $1 trillion. $500 billion will be printed by Germans, the British, the French. All these countries are printing notes and pumping money in the economy just to boost the economy, boost the demand. When so much of cash is floating around and there is little goods in the market because the goods are not there, you can very easily print notes. You can't print goods. Goods will take time. Printing note is very easy. And if so much of currency is floating around and little goods are there, the only thing will happen is the prices will go up.
Inflation.
And when the prices go up, what happens? You purchase more. Because you think that tomorrow the prices will be even more, so buy it today. See, earlier what was happening was that people, in the anticipation of prices going down, that the flat prices will come down, you were postponing decision to buy. Now that you are anticipating that the prices might go up because it is already going up, you will buy more than what you require. This is the psychology always works. I had seen when India was under a license permit raj, where when you have to wait for 17 years to get a Fiat car, 1.5 years to get an ambassador, third grade ambassador car. That time people used to book 20 cars when they didn't need one car. Yeah, in the anticipation they'll sell it on premium. And there was a premium on everything, from Bajaj scooters to everything, there was a premium in the market. On the budget day, we used to sell till middle of the night. And even the defective pieces of air conditioners and TV used to get sold, because people used to expect that tomorrow the prices will go up, so let's buy whatever is available today. When goods shortage happens, the market goes up. People buy more. And when the manufacturers will see that the market is wanting more, the people who are running one ship will run two ships. People who are running two ships will run three ships. Because there's a demand of the product in the market, why should they not increase their production? They should maximize. And when they increase from one ship to two ship, what will happen? The shift will not increase unless they start hiring more people. So there'll be more hiring than less hiring. There'll be more hiring than firing.
True.
Let me show you today in the Economic Times, there is a heading on the front page which said, "We have jobs, give us workers, FMCG to the government." The headline says, "We have jobs, where are the workers?"
Yeah.
Workers are all gone home. So the fear that, you know, people will get fired, that they may get fired for a temporary period of 2-3 months or 6 months, but ultimately there'll be a big hiring. And this will not only happen in India, it will happen worldwide, because we have to make up for this 6 months of production loss. How will we make up? By running more shifts. And running more shifts, you require more people. And more people means more hiring than firing. So where is the recession? I can't see any recession. And let me tell you, when there is such a pandemic happens, great thing happens. You see, most of the discoveries in the world, you know, in Europe happened when there was a bubonic plague in London. You know, the Newton wrote his book, you know, the famous book where the gravity force, and while he was confined in his house when there was a bubonic plague in London. When there was a recession in IT industry in 1970s and people were losing jobs, Narayan Murthy and his team has to leave Putney Computers. They couldn't get a job in any other IT companies because they had all are going through recession. That is the time he decided that since we don't have job, let's start our own company. And borrowing 10,000 rupees from Sudha Murthy, he started a company in one bedroom of his 800 square foot flat. That company is today India's pride. I think a lot of people who are temporarily going to be sacked or lose jobs during this period will create more Infosys. It has happened in the past. All recessions has created world-class companies.
Yep.
Why do you think it will not happen this time? So there is nothing to be, it's an opportunity to see when there is a shortage of goods and the market wants more than what is can be produced. That is the time when there's a new entrant can enter.
Yes.
When the existing player is struggling to sell, they will not let any newcomer to come. But when the existing player is unable to meet the demand of the market, new player can easily come. Because there's so much for everybody. When I am not able to sell my flat, do you think a new builder will be able to come and sell? Difficult. But when the demand is so much that I can't produce so much of flat which the market wants, then a newcomer come and meet that unsatiated demand. So I think a lot of new businesses will also come, will develop during this time, because there'll be a boom time. So it's going to be a great time. Why should we feel depressed and negative and talk about all these recessions and depressions? I really don't understand. So
are you open to check? Are you open to take some questions? Couple of people.
Yeah. I'm open now. This is all I wanted to share with you. Now I'm open to take some questions if you have. Please go ahead. And
super insight. First of all, it's a super insight, and we are blessed to have this wisdom. It's a complete filtered, real-time, real-life experience and understanding. So over to you, Mr. Agarwal. Mr. Pankaj Agarwal wanted to ask some question. Please turn on your... Yep. Over to you.
Yeah. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Well, I agree with what you said about, the supply-demand thing, and there will be a upsurge in demand due to shortage of supply. But what about the essentials and non-essentials things? When we talk about real estate, it's like a non-essential things. And we talk about consumable things like bhujia and food products. That's an essential thing. Okay, so we can see upsurge in essentials, but in real estate...
Why do you think the real estate is unessential? You don't want to have a roof over your head.
No, people do have a roof over their head on a rentals, but when it comes to buying a rent, house, just, that's a just, big decision.
See, let me tell you, Mr. Agarwal, I was living in a house, rented house, all my life, where my son had to sleep on a sofa. And his legs were, he was taller than the sofa, he was not able to sleep properly. For me, was buying a house was essential or not essential?
No. Okay. Could be. I have framed it in a wrong manner because.
Let me tell you another incident. We have developed a property on Baligan Circular Road. Okay. Where four brothers' wives, when separated, one was having a kitchen under the staircase. Another was cooking outside the house in a veranda. Third was cooking on the roof, and fourth was cooking at the back side of the building. We had developed the property. Everybody got a flat. After they got a decent flat, their thinking changed. Their children started doing well in their college, in their schools. The eldest brother's daughter had her engagement broke. She changed. She ultimately went to America. Their personality changed. Everything changed. And you still call it is not essential.
No, sir. Could it be I have framed the wrong word? But see, I'm a real estate consultant. And in last 3 months, I have seen, a lot of slump in demand. People are not coming. We hardly get any business. I haven't done business in last 3 months.
You should
before that, at least people were... at least coming for inquiries, but now people are not even coming for inquiries. So that is what, seeing that, I have this question, like, will real estate
recent publication of Realty Plus, please go and see, they have showed 10,000 flats being sold in the last, and I don't, I don't doubt this 10,000 flat figure, because, the Lodas, they have said that, they have sold, and they have given actual figures. They have given the name of the customers who have bought. So there's, it's not that all these figures are fudged. At PS, we have sold more than 60 flats. I can give you all the names of the customers. Why they are buying it now? Because earlier they were, had no time. Now that they are confined in a house, they are able to talk among themselves. The wife is there. The children are there. They are having enough time to get offers from different builders. They can compare the plans of all the builders, and then they can decide. They have nothing else to do, so they have taken their decision of buying was getting postponed because they were involved in so many other things which were taking the priority. Now that they have time, they have decided, because anyway they wanted to buy the flat. It is only that the paucity of time was not letting them decide. Now they are able to decide. So I'm not saying, see, the sales are definitely less than the normal time sales, but then sales are happening. At least 25% sales are happening, but there is no production happening. So this 25% sales multiplied by 6 months or 1 year will amount to enough sale so that this entire baggage of unsold flats will get sold, liquidated. So builders will have no baggage. They are now encashed all their dead stock. I will put it this way. The same thing will happen for a textile industry. Textile always have huge amount of dead stock. But the dead stock get cleared when there is absolute shortage of material in the market. When there's nothing available, they'll buy whatever is available. This is the mindset of the consumer. Because somebody wants something today and he's not getting, he'll buy whatever is available. I had seen this happening when I was in retail of consumer durables. When no AC is available, only one AC is available, it is dented. You cannot sit in your house in this hot summer without an AC. You will buy that AC. You will think that if I miss this chance, somebody else will take and I'll not get this. You will buy whatever is available. This is the mindset.
True.
Okay. See, the moment you realize that you will not get a flat, you will buy whatever is available. Okay. You only decide
when
too many things are available.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
In fact, I can give you a fact, like in this pandemic situation, Russia is buying lot of clothes, pure non-toxic clothes, and they are actually importing that. It's not that business actually stopped. Things are rosy and there is no supply. There is a gap that happened. And it's a fact. It's happening. So I don't believe that there is a doomsday that's coming. I mean, I agree with, completely agree with sir. With this note, I think we can shift to another question. Abhishek is asking that he wants to start some small MSME in villages. Which sector is best?
This is a very different, difficult question. Which sector is best is very different, difficult to say. Today, the finance minister has offered a lot of soaps for building these supply chain things, you know, cold storages and, food grain storage, this thing. And, so I think you should go and see that the government is going to give a lot of incentives and support to all kinds of things which are non-existent in the rural markets. And therefore, I think any of that should be a good area of investment or business.
So we have the president of ELMA, Mr. Rajiv K. Poddar, with us, and he runs Smart Power Technologies in Calcutta. Rajiv, I have already unmuted you. Would you please address sir, and if you have any question on behalf of the ELMA, you can address the same.
Thank you. It's a nice time talking to sir, and I am very delighted to see sir's view that at this time there will be the boom may be coming. So I don't have really a question in my hand, and I hope and wait that the such thing will come and we will learn new thing from this pandemic and India will go forward.
And at this hour, Rajivda, most probably you are doing some super cool product development. I can see that from the social media. You have, in this hour, you have developed products and you start. In fact, we know a couple of
people
who are doing large amount of business. We have members who are doing large
amount of business.
So do you feel that business is not happening, rather it's increasing or the number of orders increased? Your thoughts?
No, some type of new demand is coming. Suppose we have developed a sanitizer tunnel. And yesterday I got more than 50 inquiries in one day. So there is a lot of demand for that product. So this is the avishakta hi avishkar ki janni hai. So this type of thing has been, new thing is coming. But as a whole market, it's difficult to say it will be booming. I believe it will be very difficult time ahead. We have to fight. But ultimately,
sir, your views, Pradeep sir.
I don't know why there will be difficult times, because you will see and go and see the shops are getting emptied. Yeah, they are not getting, there's no unsold stocks. The shops, everything is getting sold. So why we think that this is a very difficult time, when I see that the shop has got only last two bags of atta. And they are not the brand which I am looking for, I'll buy it. Yeah, because I know I'll not get this atta tomorrow. So I'll go and buy it. Same thing. See, I think you are all young generation. You have no idea of what happened or how India was in pre-1991 era, when there was a, we are running in shortages. Yeah, well, we have to, you know, everything was in short supply. Do you know that there was a time when you had to wait for 20 years to get a landline telephone, which half the time didn't work? And you had to pay 10,000 rupees premium to get that stupid phone. How will you do business without a phone? Today, you will not even touch that phone. Yeah, that was the condition of the phone. And because that was the only thing available, you have to buy. Today, we see, okay, which model is remote, which channel, which Airtel mein achha nahi aata hai connectivity, ye lo. Aapke paas choice hai, isse aapko baat aati hai. Jab shortage ho jayegi, to mindset hi change ho jayega.
Yes.
You will buy whatever is available in the market. And this is going to happen because unfortunately everything is closed. And it will be a great task. You see, I know if you are, I was just seeing one factory which is producing, this cell phone, and they have been asked to start the factory with 25% workforce. So that's a condition. So out of four lines of production, they are only using one line of production. Obviously, their production is only 25% of their rated capacity. If everyone is producing 25% of their rated capacity, just imagine, and your demand, let's say, it will coming down from 100% to 80%. Still, there is a big supply-demand mismatch. And when there is a supply-demand mismatch, you will pay whatever price the person asks. And let me tell you one thing. In manufacturing, if I increase the price by, let's say, 10%, my profit increases by 100%. Because my profit is only that 10%. So if you increase the price by 10%, which consumer can easily pay in a shortage economy, the profitability of the company goes by 100%. And if every company start showing their results as 100% more than previous year, what do you think is going to happen in the stock market?
Super insight, sir. Super insight.
So I don't see any reasons of, difficult time and recession and doomsday and all these things.
Okay, so we have got another last question. Mr. Das is asking, Pradeep ji, ultimately we need to manufacture. A situation may arise when raw material stock can be more and we need to manufacture.
Sir, your raw material is also a product of somebody else. If you are having difficulty in producing, he's also having difficulty in producing. So don't think there will be a huge stock of raw material. You will be rather having a shortage of raw material also. We are already facing in construction industry. I can tell you, share with you, there was a time when you have to get a permit to get cement in this country. You need to have a permit to get steel in this country. Yeah, without permit, you couldn't get steel. There was a shortage of steel and cement. Yeah, I've seen those days. Same thing is going to come here because the steel and cement will be short in short supply, at least for 6 months or 1 year.
True. Thank you so much, sir. Do you have any more question? Else we are good to close the session, or we can continue if you wish. We have booked another session. We can continue in the same link. Maybe 1:30 seconds gap will happen in between, but we can continue. Audience, please. Sir,
I had a question.
Sure.
Sir, the WHO printed a news few days back that this coronavirus is not going to get over. The people are saying that new normal has come. We have to do things according to that. So do you think that there will be any change? You are saying that there's no doomsday, but certainly there will be some changes and people need to get adapt to it. They need to make strategies for that.
Yeah, definitely. We have to make strategies for that. We'll have to form, all of us may have to wear, mask, which is anyway good because you see, it will not only protect you from corona, it will protect you from all other viral related diseases. You will also get less affected by influenza, by flu, by dengue, by all kinds of things. You see, my mother is still in the hospital in the ICU, and we were just discussing with the chief of the ICU, and he said, right now, it is a bit safer in hospitals and in the ICU because everybody is wearing a mask, everybody is taking extra precaution, and this is not only going to prevent the the patients and other people to get protected from corona, because the same thing is also protecting you from many other kind of infections. So it's actually becoming a safer place to go than a normal circumstances. So it's good. See, a lot of good things I can tell you about the corona. Your entire planet was at stake because of global warming, because yes, you were creating so much of pollution. You were not stopping, and nothing would make you stop. Now this small virus has come and you are behaving yourself. Yeah, the whole world is becoming a better place to live. Why are you complaining?
Thank you so much, sir.
We will learn how to stand. We will learn how to stand in a queue. We will learn how to talk with the person.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Not waste unnecessary time and energy and fuel to make unnecessary trips by air, by car. You can do all these things with this kind of Zoom meetings. You know, why should you travel all the time?
No point. Thank you so much, sir, for the insights. Lovely question, audience. Thank you so much. So I take the place to conclude this meeting. Thank you so much. Looking forward for more wisdom and more knowledge and more talks from you, sir. And we'll be blessed by the knowledge that you have. Really, thank you. Thank you, audience.
Thank you so much. Thank you.